student and channel manager at UPST, master at information and communication engineering. Today I will present you about my research here that currently have been before. The title is Machine Learning Based Voice Impact Prediction at Electric Vehicle Charging Station. This research is conducted by me with team Olafite and my professor, Professor Mingdai Huang. So first I will tell you the background of my research here. Nowadays, electric vehicles have been recognized as a promising approach to reduce our traffic emission from conventional electric vehicles like petroleum vehicles that conventional nowadays. And the electric vehicle promises to have a better energy conversion efficiency and it has less of greenhouse gas emission or GHG. However, one of the critical challenges in fully adopting the EVs and vehicle is the lack of the charging stations. So, although it is predicted that sufficient number of charging stations will be constructed in the future eventually, like for example nowadays, Hyundai and other car manufacturers already have built and sell to the masses of the electric vehicles, but nowadays there's not much really on public electric vehicles provided by the government, so I think it is one of the problems of this current situation. So finding the best option for charging station located in a town is also important, since there's only a limited charging station available, especially in here in my currently studying in Changwon National University. Changwon City has only limited charging station available. So providing information about the nearest and the most suitable charging station will be helpful for the EV drivers in the future. Nowadays, everyone wants to migrate into more eco-friendly technology. So in order to move from petroleum-based to electric vehicles, one of the ways that I propose is to provide is this one. So this is the solution that I propose here is we will create a system that provides information regarding of the charging station availability in the form in the mobile application. So the system could also determine the electric vehicle movements, whether it's the vehicle is coming into the charging station or they coming out from the charging station. Moreover, we will have a prediction system with machine learning algorithm to predict the charging station for the occupancy. So basically, it's just like a weather forecast, like maybe hourly or daily, you can say that in this hour, they have a prediction of 10 vehicles in the charging station, and in the next hour, maybe less, 5 vehicles, and the next hour, maybe 3, and so on, so on. So we will create a future prediction for the charging station. Okay, after the background of my research, I will tell you about my system configuration. So here is the figure of my system configuration. So it starts from the charging station in a CS. So in step one, the charging station, we will install the camera here, and it will record the vehicle position and the movement. So for example, when a car is coming into the charging station to charge, it will be recorded with the camera. And the PC server located in the near charging station will count the number of vehicles with machine learning object detection algorithm that I already prepared. And then the PC server also create a future prediction, a forecast, with the information of the number of cars that are available in the charging station and some environmental data like time of day, temperature, humidity, and etc. And next step, from here, the DC server will send the charging station and the prediction information to the Firebase database server. So why I use Firebase database server? Because Firebase is one of the databases and directly connected from a PC into the mobile application to the multiple mobile users. And in the Firebase database, the server will respond to the request from the PC server and save all the data of the object detection, the number of vehicles. The Firebase database will also send the information stored in the database into the mobile users in the form of communication. So, whenever users and IP drivers complete the mobile application, in the mobile application we install a map feature to check the condition and availability of the charging station and the weather information also. Because I'm also open a prediction feature on the application to make a schedule of plan ahead so they can see when is the best time, best possible time for them to charge their battery. Okay, next this is the our environment of my hardware. This is the currently I'm using this web camera, and this web camera will record some simulation here. And in this simulation here, I run with the Python code that I run in Python code. And here for this is the example, the screenshot of my PC. And in here we can see with this web camera and in this view from the web camera, we have some frame and this imaginary Chinese station we have currently here, one car. And this one car is that's in here, it's already finished charging, so then we move out. So it will come as out. So in the object detection, record detection, we will create imaginary boundaries that I will explain in this next slide. So next is how the object detection is conducted. So in this research, I will use mobile accessibility. Object detection is the one of the kind of famous object detection algorithm. It's like the YOLO, you only look once. And in here, I use the mobile net SSD version 1. And currently, there's also mobile SSD version 3, but maybe I will try to use it later for the next future research. So, with the mobile net SSD, I use help of the OpenCV to create the direct link from camera into my Python code or the PC. And in the code, we will have a function, a feature called the sample tracker. So basically when in an object detection we have a boundary window, right? For example, there's a car, usually we have a detection window like this square of the object. And centrally means the center of the detected image. There's a lot of algorithm or mathematical operation that algorithm that count how to determine whether it is centroid. And with the centroid tracker, this Python code will always targeting where is the centroid of the detected object. Or in this example here, in the bounding loop set, we have the detected ID, we classify it as an ID number 1. And the centroid will always be marked and tracked. So whenever the object is moved, the centroid is also moved. Or same as for the ID number 2, the object number 2. Whenever the centroid is moving, the code will track wherever the movement for the centroid. So by tracking the centroid, we can create the imaginary boundaries. For example, here this is my first stage of my research. We create some there's a line, yellow line here. You can see there's a line here. So the line function has a boundary to decide in here. perspective, Android is moving out from the boundaries, like in this image 2, in the left side image. And this green car is leaving, and the centroid is in the left side of the boundaries. It will be depicted as up. So the code will count how many cars left in charging station and it's for calculating. Next is for the database. So the database, which is the file database, I already explained a little before. So in the database, I will save a lot of information. Basically, like whenever whenever something changes, whenever the car is coming in or coming out, and the counting numbers change, it will trigger some trigger the database, the PC server, to send new information to the database. So basically, you can see in my database project here, this is every instance of a new detected new information, right? So in the information here, I put some address of the charging station. Here, the address is a dummy or a simulation of the address. Because in research, I research in MATLAB environment. So the other information is how many cars on the charging station, and how many in charging, and how many cars in call, and which is the date, the current date of the information. And this is the charging station ID. So the plan is, what is this mean? Because the plan is, first, I want this system builds only once charging station simulation. And then the next step, we will create another and more charging station. So we can differentiate, this is the charging station one condition, this is charging station two condition, and this is charging station condition. So it's with this ID of the charging station. Next is the information of how many charging ports available in the charging station. And this is, like I told before, it's just a simulation of that information. So we have four. Next is the address application. If you can see here in the image, I put map feature with a Kakao Maps API. So in the Kakao Maps API, we can use some navigation searching and navigation features with the help of Kakao Maps API. So users can only just like using normal GPS, can use this scroll and find where which is the closest and the best option, the best possible option for charging. And whenever the user click the charging station here, in here I put my address, our campus address, and one at the university. And when we click the balloon here, it will go to the charging station information page. So an information page is basically the data, same data as from the Firebase database. And in this table here, we put a history. So in the history, you can say that like in last hour, it's increasing or decreasing. Next, also we have our prediction graph here. So prediction graph, I will explain in the later minute. So prediction. The prediction system goals are to give an insight and allow users to create a forecast into the future event. So we can say the prediction will look like this weather forecast. Like for example, yesterday we have temperature of this kind of temperature, and today this kind of this one, and tomorrow and so on and so on. So in order to create a prediction modeling, we need some data, right? So first data is a generated number of electric vehicles in the charging station. And another data we collected is an environmental data, such as the time of the day, is it night or the day, by the hour, and temperature and humidity, and as far as we use it, it's only temporary and immediate conversion. So in prediction, we will use some machine learning algorithm, and here we choose a support vector regression, or SVR, as our predictive analytic to generate the prediction outcome. So basically, in support vector machine or support vector regression, we will have some hyperplane, right? And we also have a margin created by the decision boundary. So the hyperplane here function as our prediction line. So basically, in the machine learning prediction regression, the prediction line is the line that created from the prediction parameter. In this result, the parameter is hour, the x is hour or day, and the y will be the collected data of the numbers of vehicles and the environmental data. So the prediction will show the correlation between in each hour in the future and how many cars will be available. Sorry, not available, but how many cars in the charging station. Then with the other is the two decision boundary here, this the red line here. It will show the margin, the gap of the prediction line. And in this lecture, I will use the decision boundary as to show the minimum and maximum number in the hourly EV prediction. So the graph of the application will show like this. The maximum maybe in today will be this one, and tomorrow will be increasing, and so on and so on. So after the prediction is generated, we will save the prediction, and the result will be sent into the Firebase database, and then the prediction information also will be sent into the mobile application. So in the visitor pro, we save the prediction as a number, a value of number, and then the number will be saved in the Firebase database, and in the database, we send a download back to the Android application, and in the Android coding, the number will be generated into a graph, a figure of graph. Next, this challenge and issue for the system. First one is the system installation. As you know, the investment for integrating system into charging station could be a challenge, since in background, I already told you that. Nowadays, there's only limited electric charging station available. So when we build charging station, we install it with the system. We also have a lot of things to configure, like where to put the camera, where is the PC, and how is the connection. And there's a lot of things that we need to consider when we install into real charging station. And camera allocation is also quite important here, because camera allocation will determine how good the system object detection performance is. Because sometimes if the training for object detection is good, I think in every angle of the vehicle it can be detected perfectly. But sometimes when the camera is maybe located too far or too far, too close, maybe some vehicles will not be detected perfectly. And also there's some changes like one a passerby car that is not charging, that only pass is also counted as in the system. So camera question is quite important. Next is data gathering for prediction system. So this is the quite problem that I've found here while I'm researching. Is first, in order to generate the prediction outcomes, we require a lot of data of daily electric vehicle charging at the charging facilities, right? But the prediction outcomes are crucial, since they can accommodate a question. So, and it is quite complex and complicated to gather the data, since the vehicle's data in charging station is not publicly available, because there's nothing, I think, in order to get some data of the recording of how many vehicles that come into the charging station, we need to build some kind of agreement or work together with the car, transportation company or government to, in order to get some predictive data for our prediction system. And also for the previous challenges for the, how to install the good infrastructure for the charging station system. Okay, next, the last thing I would say is our conclusion. So this system can determine the amount of movement vehicles entering and leaving the charging station in real time with the an address application as the user interface. So the system aims to help the EV drivers so they don't need much time to navigate and where to charge their EVs. And in the current state of the my system, our system uses the dummy charging facility as simulation to create in our lab. We also generated electric vehicle data with some calculations. So, since it's only a simulation, actually we'll upgrade the system to manage the multiple charging stations, not only one simulated environment. And moreover, to improve the performance of object detection feature, we also can consider to try to implement more advanced object detection and more tracking with the latest object detection, maybe mobile net version 3 or maybe YOLO.